In this learning module, we will take a high-level look at the options available for saving and exporting what you have accomplished with your analysis efforts. These include considerations regarding how the analysis document is saved relative to the supporting data, and the ability to capture fixed states from a dynamic analysis process in order to return later or share those saved states with others. A capability designed for just that purpose is the bookmarks capability. As you are performing an interactive analysis and you think to yourself, "This is great. I need to be certain to remember these settings. Don't mark any more data, don't reset the filters, and don't rearrange visualizations until you first add a bookmark." The bookmark will save all of the aspects of the analysis listed here, making it easy to return to that state anytime you wish. If you do not wish to capture all of these aspects of the analysis, you can add Bookmark Special, and you will be presented with the option to select which of these aspects you wish to save as part of your bookmark. Bookmarks are originally presented in a popover dialog. However, if you wish to dock them as a fixed panel on the page, like the filters or details on demand panels, just look for the pin icon. Another way of capturing a fixed snapshot of the current state of your analysis is to export a visualization or visualizations. Options available include the ability to export a single visualization as an image, or export multiple visualizations to PDF, PowerPoint, or web-compatible file types which support an HTML document. If you elect to export to PowerPoint, the elements which make up an image may be ungrouped and edited. In addition to the visual endpoints you have achieved throughout an analysis, the data you have isolated may also be of interest. You may export the data in a visualization. This can be especially useful if you create a cross table or summary table and wish to work with those values in another application, like Excel. You may also export any of the subsets of data currently identified by markings in the analysis, or rows you have filtered to using a specific filtering scheme in your analysis. If the data contains column types which are not supported by text or Excel file types, you may consider exporting as an SBDF file. When exporting data to the library, an SBDF data source result, and may be shared with Business Author client users as a starting point for their analyses. As you prepare to save your analysis, it's time to think again about the nature of the analysis document relative to the underlying data table or data tables. Be certain to consider them as separate but integrated items. You will need to understand how each of the data tables in your analysis document is configured relative to the original data source for that data table. And keep in mind that if you used insert columns or insert rows in order to add data to an existing data table, there may be more than one data source supporting a single data table. For many data sources, the path to that data source or data sources is all that is saved within the analysis document by default. However, the Data Table Properties dialog provides the option to leave each data table linked to the source, or you may elect to embed a data table within the analysis document, thereby making the data source layer no longer necessary and creating an analysis document which can stand alone and be shared with others without concern for their ability to access the data. The two store data options in this dialog may not be available if you copied and pasted the data from the clipboard, or if you created a connection to an in-database data source and elected to keep the data external. In addition to deciding how you wish to save the analysis relative to the data which supports that analysis, you will need to choose where you wish to save that analysis document. The Analyst client provides two options for saving an analysis document. First, it can be saved as a file. This saves your analysis document into a Windows directory on your computer or network, just like the files from other applications, and the resulting file has a .dxp extension. The second option is to save your analysis as a library item. This stores the analysis in a directory-like structure which exists on the Spotfire server, called the library. The folders in the library can be configured with permissions to allow only specific Spotfire users or groups to read or write to the contents of that folder. One of the advantages of saving an analysis to the library is that it becomes available to consumer client users. In addition, sharing an analysis with other client users via the library ensures that any JavaScript and Iron Python scripts which are included within the analysis document are trusted. Sharing an analysis as a DXP file will cause these scripts to become untrusted. Let's take a look at a brief demonstration during which some of the saving and exporting capabilities are pointed out. Use Open File and navigate to the example with Save and Export Overview in the title. Click Open and agree to the terms and conditions of use. The data supporting this analysis has been collected from customers shopping at our chain of Megamart department stores. Based upon that data table, two pages of visual data analysis have been configured. On this page, we might wish to mark a group of customers in this scatter plot, filter to display data from only our male customers, and mark the pie chart sector representing the Los Angeles store location in order to view that data in the Details on Demand panel. If we are happy with this state of the analysis and may want to return to it later, we could capture a bookmark using this icon. Type a name for the bookmark, like My Interesting View, and click the Add Bookmark button. Now, when we proceed with our analysis by clearing the marked data from the pie chart, limiting data to only female customers, and marking a different subset of data in the scatter plot, returning to our interesting view is as easy as returning to the bookmark icon and double-clicking in order to apply the saved bookmark. If we wanted to export the visualizations on this page in their current state to a PDF document, we could go to File, Export to PDF. After we click Export in the resulting dialog and give the PDF document a name, we can click Save and review the resulting document. Returning to Spotfire, if we wanted to export the data we have identified through marking and filtering in this analysis, we could go to File, Export, Data to File, and select Data Table, where both the filtered rows and either of the subsets of data defined by marking may be exported. When we click OK, provide a name for the data export, and select the desired export file type, we can click Save, and evaluate the exported rows in Excel. Returning to Spotfire, let's clear both of the markings, first by clicking where there is nothing in the pie chart, then by clicking where there's nothing in the scatter plot. Finally, we will reset the filters. Let's assume that we've decided to create a simplified version of our analysis, and in that version, we no longer wish to include this second page of visual analysis. We could right-click on the tab in order to delete this page, then right-click on this tab in order to rename the page, removing the page 1 designation. Now we want to save both these changes and the bookmark we created as a new analysis document. We can go to File, Save As, and note that here is where we will determine if we want to save the analysis to the library or as a file to be saved within our Windows directory. We will choose File, and the resulting dialog will indicate the current settings for the data table supporting the analysis document. It is currently embedded. We could click the Edit button if we wanted to change this setting to save only a link to the source, assuming that the data source is available to us, and the next time the analysis is opened, it will read the data from that data source and populate the visualizations with the most current data. Let's click OK and click OK. The analysis document should be provided with a new name, and we can click Save in order to complete the process.